Stars form when large molecular clouds collapse and the pressure increases in the center. And it increases so far that individual nuclei of hydrogen, so protons, overcome the Coulomb barrier and fuse together to form new isotopes and elements. And the moment this happens is the moment when a new star is born, or the ignition of a star. And the sequence of fusion reactions that can then happen in stars is shown here, and I will briefly go through this. So at the beginning, there are two hydrogen atoms fusing together, and therefore this first step here is called the hydrogen burning. In hydrogen burning, two hydrogen atoms fuse to form deuterium. And this is then used together with another hydrogen to form helium. So here is the first new element formed. This is helium-3, so two protons, one neutron, and these together can then form helium-4. And after these first fusion steps producing helium, the helium can be used to go to the next burning stage, which is then the helium burning. And for example, our sun will reach helium burning, but this will then be the end. Our star is simply too small, the sun is simply too small to increase the pressure sufficiently to produce even heavier elements than those produced in helium burning, or in the first stages of helium burning. What's happening here is that helium, for example, forms beryllium, which is then used together with helium to form carbon-12, and this is then used together with helium to form oxygen. After this, helium burning, or the next step that then comes, is the CNO cycle. It's called cycle because the element at the beginning here is also produced at the end, which means that this entire cycle of fusion can start over. So let me show this. It starts with carbon-12 forming nitrogen-13. And by the way, there's always some gamma rays or electrons or neutrons formed, but I'm neglecting these here to be a bit more brief. So then the nitrogen is used to form carbon, which is used together with hydrogen to form nitrogen 14 in this case. This is then used to form oxygen, which is used to form nitrogen 15 then. And then this nitrogen 15 here together with hydrogen again produces carbon 12 together with helium. Now at the end here there's carbon 12, which was also at the beginning of this, which means the cycle is complete and can start from the beginning. After this CNO cycle, there's a carbon burning, and in carbon burning, a couple of isotopes like 24 magnesium, 23 magnesium is formed, sodium, neon, and so on. Of course, there are then many more elements also produced during these kind of sequences here. And after this, oxygen burning can start. For this, we need really very massive stars. And these together form, for example, sulfur, phosphorus, or silicon. And then finally, in the most massive stars, the silicon can be used to ultimately produce iron. Now this, it is required that in order to produce very heavy elements, the pressure must be very high in the stars. So only very massive stars can produce these. But it's not entirely true that only elements up to 56 iron can be produced. It's usually said because these elements produce energy during fusion, while heavier elements require energy to be produced. These are usually formed in supernovas, for example. But it's still possible to form some heavier elements, but typically, or mostly, these elements here are formed. This is what is called the stellar nuclear synthesis. As said, our sun will go up to helium. For other others, much more massive stars are required. And this is about a sequence that happens in various shells also within stars, and this is how all these elements can be produced.